Hi, it's July, so Home Assistant comes with the July update release 2024.7. It includes some interesting new features such as resizing the cards on your dashboard, data table improvement, taking control over blueprints, and some new integrations. I will show you how to use all these features in this video. Let's do this! The new July release of 2024.7 of Home Assistant is here. Note that this video is based on the beta version of this release, so there might be some minor changes in the final release, which will come out on the first Wednesday of July. Let's see what's new in this release. A few months ago, sections were introduced in dashboards. Sections allow you to organize your dashboard more flexibly. In this new release, an option has been added to adjust the size of cards within your sections. This means you no longer always need to use horizontal stack, vertical stack, or grid cards to customize your layout. How you can adjust the layout depends on each card. In this new version, it's now possible to organize the columns in data tables according to your preferences. You can make columns visible or invisible and change the order of the columns. Your column settings are saved in your browser, so your preferences are preserved. As you know, I regularly create blueprints for videos to make it easier for you to implement the code I explain into your own Home Assistant installation. Sometimes you ask me to make changes to those blueprints so that a specific use case will work for you as well. I only do this if it's an adjustment that could be important for multiple people. If you don't know how to create blueprints, you can watch this video where I explain how to make blueprints. However, with version 2024.7 of Home Assistant, you can now convert blueprints into automations or scripts, allowing you to modify the automation yourself afterward. You can't yet convert this automation back into a blueprint, but who knows, maybe the Home Assistant team will come up with a function for that someday. This new release naturally includes several new integrations, which you can find on this page. The integration that stands out to me the most is the Mealy integration. Some time ago, I made this video explaining how to install and integrate Mealy into Home Assistant. With the new Mealy integration, you can now integrate Mealy into Home Assistant even more easily. Additionally, the camera on your tablet is now supported if you use the fully kiosk integration. And the feed reader integration can now also be activated from the UI. This means that the instruction to do this via the configuration.yaml file, as I explained in this video, is no longer necessary. The rest of the video is still valid though. These were the major changes in Home Assistant 2024.7. Additionally, other noteworthy changes are worth mentioning. You can find these in this list. The most notable one for me is that Home Assistant will now raise a repair issue if an automation cannot be set up. This resulted in quite a lot of repairs in my case because some devices couldn't be found anymore. Oh, and you can now easily adjust the radius around your house. With each new version, some changes will no longer work in older versions, so always read through the list of backward-incompatible changes carefully before you update. If you use Open Weather Map and still use the old way of getting the forecast, then be aware that this will be removed in this version and you need to use the new way of retrieving forecasts. Watch this video to learn how you can do this. Please note that this video is based on the beta version of Home Assistant 2024.7, so there may be slight variations from the final release scheduled for this upcoming Wednesday. Thanks for watching. If you like what you see, please consider supporting this channel to help it grow. You can find links to my Patreon, Ko-fi and channel membership in the description below. A huge thank you to all our sponsors. Your support is essential for sustaining the channel and I am deeply grateful to each of you. And remember to like this video and subscribe to the channel. This helps the channel a lot. I will see you soon in my next video. Bye bye! Based on the beta. It's based on the beta.